स्टूडेंट टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द एडिपोज टिश्यूज. सो दिस इज वन काइंड ऑफ कनेक्टिव टिश्यूज ऑल्सो. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ टिश्यूज और कैन से दैट द दोज टिश्यूज कंटेन द सेल्स फिल्ड विथ फैट और ग्लोब्यूल्स इज कॉल्ड द एडिपोज टिश्यूज. सो एडिपोज टिश्यूज, दिस इज योर एडिपोज टिश्यूज. दिस एडिपोज टिश्यूज कंटेन द फैट्स एंड इफ यू सी द ब्रॉडली दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ द फैट सेल एंड कंटेन सम फैट्स इज प्रेजेंट. सो दिस एडिपोज टिश्यूज, you can say that the tissues which contains the fat is called the adipose tissues. Now coming to the point, the skeletal tissues. The skeletal tissues, this is one type of connective tissues and connects the various other tissues and organs, as well as it provide the support to different organ. Okay, so skeletal tissues is one kind of connective tissues. Okay, the two part of it, that is your one bone and one cartilage. So see, actually connective tissues three kind. If you broadly classified the connective tissues is three types. One is supportive connective tissues, one is fibrous connective tissues, and another is fluid connective tissues. Supportive connective tissues, that is your bone and cartilage part, and the fibrous connective tissues, that is your tendon and ligament, that actually I have been discussed earlier, and the fluid connective tissues, that is your blood and lymph, that I will discuss in next slide. So this skeletal tissues, or you can say that this bone and the cartilage, this is one kind of skeletal tissues, or you can say that this is one kind of connective tissues that is act as a supportive connective tissues. So what is actually your bone? So bone, it is the main supportive structure of vertebrates. The bone cells are embedded in the hard matrix of calcium and phosphorus cell. We know that in bones, both calcium and phosphorus are present. Okay, so the bone is the main supportive structure of vertebrates, and the matrix of the deposited in the form of concentric layers and around a central canal, and the bone cell occupy the small spaces, and that particular spaces is accumulate the calcium and phosphorus salt. So calcium is very important for us and phosphorus is not important. If somehow the phosphorus is increasing so much, so that time many kind of disease may occur. So calcium is important, phosphorus is not too much important, phosphorus salts in your bones. Okay, now coming to the point, that is called cartilage. See, cartilage actually covers the end of the bones and gives support to the central certain organs, such as tip of the nose, external projection of the ear and the windpipe. So this cartilage tissues in your ear also. So if you see the ear, then you can see that the particular part of your ear, that can you can easily fold it, you can easily twist it, and you can easily press it, and it can easily reverse to the your normal shape also. So cartilage tissue is very smooth tissues, you can say that. Okay, so two part of the skeletal tissues, or you can say the supportive connective tissues, that is your bone and your cartilage. So bone is the main supportive structure of the vertebrate. This is the one other part of the skeletal tissues, and your cartilage is the very malleable, or you can say that the very smooth tissues that can easily twist, that can easily fold, that can easily pressed, and again it can come back in its normal shape also. Okay, here is in here it is present. Now coming to the point, what is muscular tissue? See, this muscular tissue, this tissue forms the muscles of the body. Okay, muscles of the body. So very important, the muscles can contract and relax. We all of you know that these things, na? Muscles can easily contract as well as they can also relax. So this help to movement and the locomotion. And this has three types. One is straight and one is unstraighted, and another is cardiac. Basically this straight, or you can say that the skeletal, or stripped, or you can say that another name is voluntary muscles. Okay. And this unstraight means this is smooth and unstripped, or you can say that the involuntary muscles. So we'll discuss these things, voluntary and involuntary muscles. एंड द थर्ड इज दैट इज कॉल्ड कार्डियक और हार्ट मसल्स. तो विल डिस्कस दिस थिंग्स, सम डिस्कशन आई विल डू हियर. सो सी दिस स्ट्रेटेड मसल्स, और यू कैन दिस सी दैट से दैट द वॉलेंटरी मसल्स. वाई वी कॉल्ड सो दिस वॉलेंटरी मसल्स? सी स्ट्रेटेड मसल्स फाउंड अटैच टू द बोन्स, ओके, आर अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ द will of an individual. That is, this type of muscles can be locomote or you can say that movements according to you, okay, like your arm muscles, that can be controlled by yourself, like your legs, like your face, like your neck also. These are the voluntary muscles. Voluntary muscles means this muscles is movement or locomoted according to yourself, according to individuals, according to how to control your other organs of your body parts. Okay, so according to yourself it can locomote. According to yourself it can be movements. That is called voluntary muscles. And the unstraight, or you can say that the involuntary muscles, those muscles are called unstraight, or can say that the involuntary muscles are not under the controls one's will. That means movement, like suppose that passage of food in the alimentary canal, for example, are caused by the contraction of the unstraight muscles in the intestinal walls, or you can say that simply, you can say that that is the muscles of your iris in your eye. So I can easily up and down. So nobody has some control in this particular side. So that particular muscles is called involuntary muscles. Those are not under the control of one's will. Means suppose that this is not under the control of yourself. That is automatically movement, or you can say the automatically locomote. That is called involuntary. Okay. So, and the cardiac muscles are those muscles, this is also the involuntary muscles. So these cells are here are the straight and comparatively short. That means cardiac means your suppose that your heart automatically rhythm day and nights, year and year. So there is no control yourself. That is not movement yourself. That is automatically do your interior side, so it can easily rhythm. So that means there is no any kind of control of yourself. So that type of muscles is called cardiac muscles. Actually, if you see the major things of this category, means cardiac muscles is also one kind of involuntary muscles. Okay, understood. Now coming to the point, that is called nervous tissues. That actually I will discuss in the next slide. Okay, thank you.